Sir, I think honorable members, some members have said they oppose this bill because this does not address the concerns of the poor. Let me tell you what our government has done over the last 5 years. Jan Dhan, 37.5 crore accounts. Deposits, 1 lakh crore deposits in Jan Dhan accounts. These are the monies which would otherwise have gone into chit funds. You did not provide for this inclusion. We provided for the poor people to save their money safely in bank accounts. 1.7 lakh crore in bank accounts. Direct benefit transfer, we transferred 7.7 lakh crore in their accounts so that they can invest, they can keep this money in their bank accounts. Under Mudra, because chits are used mainly to raise, to take credit from the other subscribers, we have provided under Mudra to 6 crore people, we have provided 3.21 lakh crores last year. And each year we have provided more than 3 lakh crores. So we have in a way obviated the need for people to really look for unsafe instruments of investment. Under various social security schemes, we have allowed farmers, the unorganized labor, to save up to get pension of 3,000 rupees in future by contributing money on a monthly basis now. These are the schemes that we have announced to obviate the need for people to go into unauthorized, irregular and untrustworthy funds. So certainly our government has done what it needs to be done. And in various other governments, we have seen how these Ponzi schemes have robbed the poor of their savings. The trust factor that Mr. Derek O'Brien was talking about is missing in West Bengal. That's the reason why thousands of crores of poor people's money was lost in Sarada scam. It was lost in Rose Valley scam, in IMA jewelry scam. We have had agri gold scam in Andhra Pradesh. In all these cases, thousands of crores of public money was robbed. And this government has brought the bill last year. Even this year, we have actually we have legislated on banning of the unregulated deposit schemes 2019, only a few months ago. This is to punish people who indulge in financial fraud and crimes. And we have actually made it punishable to the tune of 10 years. So the present government has ensured that the poor people of this country do not have to deposit their money in unsafe, irregular deposit schemes. And we have also provided for the punishment of the culprits and the perpetrators of those crimes. And those who have not done similar, who have not provided similar legislative framework for the poor in the past, I think have no basis to oppose it now. Thank you.
Thank you.